Greetings. I recently mirrored a video by Acts 17 Apologetics. The video irrefutably proves that Allah commits shirk. The video is logically perfect and an excellent reference source. I challenge every Muslim on earth to look up every case where Allah commits shirk. Please, oh please, try to find any surah cited that are not correctly cited, word for word. It is based on one central command of Islam and Muhammad. Do not swear by anything other than Allah. Swear only by Allah. Now, as a basic principle, which Muhammad stole from the Torah and Bible, it makes reasonable sense. Hebrews 6:16. For men verily swear by the greater, and an oath for confirmation is to them an end of all strife. When men swear, they do so to establish an oath. They do so to give their statement the power of a greater source. For men verily swear by the greater. And this is also the same basic claim which Islam tries to make. Only swear by Allah because Allah is supposed to be the greatest.
Shirk, in Islamic terminology, means associating partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you associate partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is shirk and is the biggest sin.
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Man halafa bi ghayri Allah, faqad ashraka aw kafar." Whoever swears by other than Allah, he has committed shirk or disbelieved.
But here is the fundamental problem for Islam. Evidently the Allah of the Quran does not understand this simple truth. You see, God made an oath to Abraham. And when God made his promise to Abraham, there was nothing greater that God could swear by. So God swore by himself. Hebrews 6:13. For when God made promise to Abraham, because he could swear by no greater, he swore by himself. The word of God is consistent with the clear logic of this matter. God swore by himself because there is no higher source to appeal to. Hebrews 6:17. Wherein God, willing more abundantly to show unto the heirs of promise the immutability of his counsel, confirmed it by an oath, that by two immutable things, in which it was impossible for God to lie, we might have a strong consolation who have fled for refuge to lay hold upon the hope set before us. For men verily swear by the greater. The Bible teaches clearly what the author of the Quran is apparently ignorant of. Because over and over, the author of the Quran swears by anything and everything other than its Allah. And that is what the video I mirrored so perfectly researches, documents, and proves. Allah commits shirk. Allah commits shirk. And I got the following post by a Mohammedan to the video. Your logic is flawed. The laws that apply to us obviously do not apply to God. Muhammad was talking to us, obviously not God. In the Bible it says, thou shalt not kill, yet God causes us to die, correct? Obviously this commandment doesn't apply to God. Also the Bible forbids sex outside marriage, right? Yet you believe that God begot a son with Mary without ever marrying her. Peace. And I got another post by another Mohammedan. It's been made clear by the Prophet that only Allah can swear by other than Allah. There's nothing new in what you're saying, mate. Who also posted this follow-up. There are several things that are forbidden for humans but are allowed to Allah, like swearing by other things, arrogance, etc. Just for you to know, I do ponder everything I hear about Islam. Many Muslims, or better to say religious people, don't, but I do and I agree with some. But honestly, this is not a good one because Muhammad has talked about it before and there is no cleverness in finding that out. Both posters seem to have been trained in the Allah can be stupid school of thought. Understand, I have not named either Mohammedan. My intent is not to embarrass them personally. My intent is to showcase the poor thinking of Islam. Remember the clear logical teaching from the Word of God. Hebrews 6:16. For men verily swear by the greater, and an oath for confirmation is to them an end of all strife. Remember the clear, consistent position God has established. For when God made promise to Abraham, because he could swear by no greater, he swore by himself. And now let's dig into the Mohammedan positions excusing Allah's stupidity. Your logic is flawed. The laws that apply to us obviously do not apply to God. To me, the flaw in that general premise is a big red flag. Oh, I agree that God is not limited to the laws that He gave men. The point here, however, is that Allah is illogical. Evidently, Allah's word cannot be trusted all by itself. Think about that. That is such a core problem for Islam. Allah's word cannot be trusted. It is no good. It has no meaning. Unless Allah appeals to a higher authority than Himself. Think about that. In the Bible, God was clearly coherent enough to know who and what to swear by. But in the Quran, Allah even swears by Muhammad's life, making Muhammad greater than Allah. Remember, that is why anyone or anything, even the God of all, swears. The next statement in the post, however, is truly revealing. Muhammad was talking to us, obviously not God. That means Muhammad wrote the command to not swear. By this, the poster is saying Allah did not. So again, Allah is oblivious to any problem with his swearing. In the Bible it says, thou shalt not kill, yet God causes us to die, correct? Obviously this commandment doesn't apply to God. You can be sure neither I nor Acts 17 Apologetics are the first to see this failure by Allah. And you can be sure this response is the same used for 1,000 years. It was logically flawed when it was created, and it is logically flawed when it is repeated. How is the Mohammedan excuse logically flawed? It is logically flawed because it assumes God is not aware of logic. By example, it allows God to give a law. Do not bear false witness, essentially do not lie, then excuses Allah for being the greatest liar, allowing Allah to lie his head off. The challenge is how to explain logic to Mohammedans who have worshipped an Allah of lies and illogic, who have no regard for logical, linear thinking. God created us. We only have rights which God gives to us. This does not preclude Him amending our rights. And this position does not require the Creator to violate logic. If Allah does not follow or understand logic, His commands will be arbitrary and capricious. his statements will be logically inconsistent, which is exactly what we see all through Islam. An oath is only used to assure or increase the certainty of a promise or statement by appealing or attaching the oath to something greater. Let that sink in. One other confusion Islam holds is that simply making an oath ascribes the greater item, the anchor of the oath, as being a partner to Allah. Saying, "I swear by the sun above," does not logically make the sun the partner of Allah. I am not saying to swear by the sun or any item. I am simply highlighting more flawed logic in Islamic dogma. Claiming Allah can prove or assure his statement by attaching them to something less than himself is illogical. Claiming Allah can increase the believability of his statements by attaching them to something less than himself is illogical. And attempting to compare pure logic to a law given by God is simply erroneous. Looking at the second post by a different Mohammedan, "It's been made clear by the Prophet that only Allah can swear by other than Allah. There is nothing new in what you're saying, mate." We can quickly see that the Prophet is covering his errors by making his sock puppet Allah look stupid. Oh, certainly, Allah can swear by other than Allah and not have Muhammad kill him. After all, Muhammad is not going to kill off the golden sock puppet. But think about this post and what it means. Muhammad is excusing the illogic of his own message. And the third post, the second by the second poster, repeats post one. "There are several things that are forbidden for humans but are allowed to Allah, like swearing by other things, arrogance, etc. Only Allah can swear by lesser things, be arrogant, commit sin, commit shirk, and so on. In fact, Allah can be imagined to do anything that excuses the illogic and error in the Quran. If Allah did it, it's all good." I think the real problem these posts exemplify is that logic has no meaning in Islam. If you call yourself Muslim, I really challenge you to take to heart the proven fact that Allah commits shirk. Oh, I'm not speaking bad about the God of Abraham. I honor and respect and submit to the God of Abraham, because the God of Abraham, Yahweh, is smart enough to understand and not swear by lesser things. Think about that. But the Allah Muhammad used as his sock puppet, he is not smart enough to get that right. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.